Marina Mahara. This is Cheryl. Behind the camera is Andre Navan.
It's the first question. So, how long have you working as a hospital chaplain?
Almost 6 years.
What are your clients?
Of course, our clients not only the patients. In this hospital, we also include our employees. Dealing with you.
How you will deal your clients?
How do you interact with them?
For the patients, of course, we are going to visit them. And you have to talk with the patients. The same thing with the employees who will come to us for counseling and some guidance. Of course, you will talk to them.
How in-depth do you get po sa conversations niyo po?
Of course, yung the clients will be sometimes yung patient namin. We need to establish the rapport for them to have trust in us. Unlike the employees, there is no need for us to do that. Patients will just short time here in the hospital. Mostly, not all, does not know us. First, we have to establish the relationship, and that is the difficult part of our dealing with those employees, because they are your friends, with each other. To be easier for us to deal with them, to talk with them, whatever their problems, it will be easier. Because they trusted us, their chaplain, unlike the patients and their families.
Do you have any standard procedure in your work?
How do you go about your day?
For example, the visitations. Yes, yeah. We put it into the policy. We have a manual that we follow in doing our tasks. For example, doing visitation, you have some standard on how to do that, including with that in doing some counseling, so some standard. In other words, we have a policy and procedure on how to do this.
Being that hospital chaplain, what can you tell about the scope of your work?
Our work is not only confined within the four walls of the institution. We go sometimes outside. Because we have a community project, and our chaplains are involved in some of our community development work. So it's for us to go outside, to go to the community, to talk with the people there.
Do you go to the patient or they do approach you?
It depends. Regards to the patient, we have a standard that we are going to visit them. There are those that will just come to us, those who are regular patients. Those coming from the churches, the CCD, so they will just drop by and inform us, Pastor, my relatives also find we need to listen. So,
are there any cases where the clients do not want to talk about their problem?
Of course. Yeah. So that's the time that the unit managers or the supervisors would refer to us to for us jumping to do that. Because our, you know, Filipinos are so very sick, so we have to do something in order for them to express their feelings.
Does it matter if your patients are of different religions?
We will never talk about their denominations or their religion. Once they are here, they are really our patient. Others would say that we don't need your visitation because we are, for example, we are INC or Jehovah's Witness. It doesn't matter to us because you are here in my hospital, so you are my patient.
How often do clients consult you?
It depends upon our relationship, actually. They are really close to us, or they are trusting us, because we developed already this relationship with this. So they come, even before us.
What can you say are the competencies of your job?
Competencies, you have the skill. Yeah. For example, the skill of listening. You really need that.
Are there others who will take over the job when you are absent? Early?
Yeah. I have my associate. And after the associate, we have some volunteer job.
What are the roles hospital chaplain should observe in attending to clients.
To be simple, you're not going to impose your faith. You're not going to impose your religion. Instead, you're there to just observe the other patient and listen to their needs, because they are really in need. So, and that is what we are going to pay for.
In what situation can the hospital say that the client needs a chaplain?
Actually, in need of the spiritual aspects, I mean, they are confined in the hospital. You have to cater to what you see. We really identify what is really our role in going to the patient. We are thinking that once we attend our clients, we are in a team. The physicians or the doctors, the nurses, the social workers, and the chaplain. So we work as a team.
Can you cite one or two of the cases that we have encountered?
Actually, in the border, so it's a problem already. once you plan already, when you start doing your business, you're doing the problems then. And I think one of the difficulties that on how really to build that relationship. That is the difficult thing. Because we consider it as a very brief encounter with the patient. So that will be the challenging one. I don't think it's a problem.
Would they personally request for it, or kayo po nagbibigay?
Actually, we have a procedure also doing that. The nurses knew it about what is the procedure in requesting the chaplain. Mm-hmm. And sometimes we give numbers. We have some limitations. I mean, chaplaincy work is only confined in the hospital. Outside, request, can you visit us?
So lastly po, Pastor, what advice or words of wisdom can you give to who aspire to be like counselors for hospital chaplains?
In counseling, it is the counseling who will take the first step. The counseling first will be the one to acknowledge that he needs that. So I hope you will think about it. It's very, very important doing counseling. It should be the gesture of the counselor to accept that he needs seeing counseling. It is not the counselor.
Thank you for that.
Thank you very much.